Hi friends, in this video we gonna see how to design a band pass and band reject filters using MATLAB software. So here in the previous example and the previous problem, we have seen how to design the low pass and high pass filters, here band pass and band reject. So the basic requirements remain the same, but here we are using a term called band. That means it is explaining about certain frequencies. Okay, first thing is band pass. Either it should pass the band of frequencies, it should pass, or band reject, or the same band of frequencies, or that band of frequency it should reject. It depends upon the band of frequencies which you give initially. Okay, the only change will be the pass band limits. You need to specify the limits up to which band you need to allow, or the which band you need to reject. Okay, now we will go into the program. So before going to a program, just want to show you the this will be the analog butterworth filter frequency response. Here you can see that as your n value is 11, n value is 3, n value is 1. As your n value is increasing, your frequency response, analog butterworth filter frequency response, is getting nearer to the ideal frequency response. Okay, so here we are dealing with the butterworth, which is maximally flat response, no ripples, nothing. Okay, in the pass band, it is flat response to the stop band. Okay, now getting back to the program here. So I'll just edit the program which has written in the previous page. Okay, here I have passband attenuation, stopband attenuation, passband frequency, and sampling frequency. This is sampling frequency. Let me put it to 2000 layer. It is stopband frequency, and I convert it into radians after this order. And after that, butter of n comma omega n. Okay, that is finished. The only difference which we get here is, here we need to specify the cutoff frequency for both the ends, pass band as well as stop band. These are the cutoff frequencies for stop band and pass band and stop band. Okay, so the rest of the thing will be the same. Okay, now we'll see the output. You can see this is the band pass filter. We know that these are certain frequencies which the filter is allowing, and the rest are attenuated. Now if I increase my sampling frequency here, might be more easier or more convenient for us. Okay, it's 38. So, you shall decrease the sampling. Okay. So, this is the magnitude response and this is the phase response here. Slowly, I am decreasing the sampling frequency so that I will get a nearer response here. The magnitude response. Okay, now if you go for band reject filter, the only difference which you can observe here is just change, or just here place a term called stop. That's it. Okay, if you place this term called stop here, your filter becomes, band pass becomes a band reject filter. See now. This is called a match filter or band reject filter. It does not allow that band of frequency, instead allows rest of the frequencies. Okay, this is the pass band, this is pass band, this is the stop band. For this. Okay. Now for this, as in the previous case, if you want to find out the coefficients and all, first I'll find it out for this one. This is the band pass filter. So band pass filter, and I need the coefficients, right? What is the cutoff frequency? I get two cutoff frequencies. For one is for pass band, one is for stop band. And what is my order? It is 4. It is 4. The same program we used for low pass filter, we got the order as 4. But here order is 2. So what change we observe is, now if I put my sampling frequency as 2000, and again if I do this, again execute it, and now if I check my N, it is 3 here. So that means the sampling frequency will decide the order of your filter. Okay, now if I use if I use more than 2000, now I'll see, I'll check for my order. I use 3000 here. Now I'll check my order, it is 4. That means when you go on increasing your sampling frequency, your order is also increasing. So I'll put it for first order filter. I'll see, I'll put it for 1000. And if I see my graph, this is like this, not an ideal one or not even nearer to that. So what the error is, the cutoff frequency must be within the interval of 0, 1. We get an order if you put 1000 as sampling frequency. It should be more than 1000. So I can increase by 500. Now I'll observe the graph. Okay, this is good. And if I check my order now, it is 2. Okay. So with the change in the sampling frequencies, there will be a change in the order also. Now remaining coefficients are A. These are the A coefficients, these are the B coefficients I get. And one more thing we are missing is, with the cutoff frequency, we got the order. Okay. These are the cutoff frequencies. So this is how we design the band pass filter. Similar is the case for band reject filter. So here I need to place a term called stop. Now if I do my, okay, this is the frequency response I get, and after that I need to check my specifications. Cutoff frequency will be the same because same filters. And next is A value, and next is B value, the same values, and order is same. So these are the band reject and band pass filter specifications which I get using this MATLAB. Okay. In the next video, we will see how we design a Chebyshev filter, low pass, high pass, band pass, and band reject filters. That's all for this video. Thank you.